on the counter behind me, I have a new continuous glucose monitor and I'm going to be putting it on. I wore one for about 9 days. You mentioned earlier that you'd seen my diet in the past be mostly fat and protein. Well, the interesting experiments that I've been doing over the last few months have been including carbohydrates. And it's so funny because I think that the word carbs colloquially gets associated with bad carbohydrates, but really carbs, carbohydrates, I'm including good carbohydrates in my diet, quote unquote, carbohydrates that are not junk food carbohydrates, they're not processed, but I've been exploring how my blood sugar reacts to those, calculating the area under the curve with my continuous glucose monitor. This is something I think you'd really enjoy if you haven't done it. I got my continuous glucose monitor from NutriSense. I'm going to do a whole podcast talking about my CGM readings, but I've been feeling pretty darn good. My favorite carbohydrate now, do you want to guess what it is?
Is it a vegetable maybe?
No, it's not. It's honey.
Sweet potato. Oh, okay. Yeah. I know that you like honey. You mentioned that before.
Yeah. I really like honey and I've been exploring different honeys, and finding that my body composition doesn't change. I feel pretty good. My weight didn't change a whole lot. My strength might've gotten a little bit better, but it's been interesting and kind of eye-opening for me to challenge my own paradigm and think, should I be in ketosis all the time? Maybe I should cycle in and out of ketosis. I did strict carnivore for over a year and a half and I never had a carbohydrate. It's been kind of fun to think, well, let's just explore, see how I feel with sweet potato, how I feel with honey.
If you remember a while back, I was like, I think I mentioned to you, I was like, dude, jam yourself with like 400 grams of carbs just so you can see what it like feels like. And you're like, I can't do it. I can't do it. But it can make you feel amazing. I mean, there definitely is, there's some really cool benefits to eating carbohydrates. But I think most of the time when talking about carbs, like if you and I are talking about like, hey man, people got to kick the carbs. We're talking about like, you know, bull crap. Foods that we're talking about junk food, we're talking about highly processed foods. We're not really saying that you can't eat a potato every day and be perfectly healthy and be in great shape, or you can't eat a couple apples or some grapes. I mean, I myself have included some fruit as of late. I made some observations about myself. Like, I'm kind of a pig, so I need to be careful about like what foods I implement, because I'll go a little haywire with them. I'll overeat. Like rice really encourages me to eat a lot more.
Yes.
And so I really can't do rice, but somebody who's thinner, who's trying to get bigger, rice might be the perfect thing for them because it's going to encourage them to eat more food. But so for me, I stick with like potatoes and fruit and things like that. And it's like a serving size, you know, I have just the one potato, like I'm allowed to have that. Things like that have been really helpful to me.
And subjectively, I've noticed that different foods affect my satiety differently within the realm of carbohydrates. I actually did white rice for a little while and it was the same thing. There was no limit to the amount of white rice that I could eat. But after a few, you know, small spoons of honey, I think, oh, that was really good. And then I'm like, you know what? I've had enough. Like, I don't need any more honey right now. Again, this is just my subjective experience, but when I sort of allowed myself to be open-minded, I thought, oh, it's pretty good. Sweet potato is also pretty good for me. I don't get a ton of kind of that endless hunger or craving happening like I did with rice, but I do think people can explore it. And that's also what's cool about a continuous glucose monitor. And again, this is a teaser for all you guys for the upcoming CGM episode. I'll show you guys on my results and talk about the nuances of how to read a CGM and use a continuous glucose monitor. You can really see like, wow, I ate white rice and my blood sugar spiked 100 milligrams per deciliter and stayed elevated for a long amount of time. And you can calculate the area under the curve of that blood sugar curve and compare it to something like honey and see a real difference. Or I believe in my case, that's what I would see. So, and that's what I have seen in the past already. So pretty interesting stuff with the CGM to help people distinguish those. And I love you point this out because people, sometimes I say, oh yeah, I'm eating, I forget what I was saying I was eating, like sweet potato. They're like, does sweet potato have carbs? And I'm thinking, what are you talking about? Of course it has carbs. Sweet potato is not carbs, but like, oh, I see. Carbs is colloquial speak for junk food carbohydrates. I get it. We're not talking, you know, detailed here, because you have your thing, war on carbs. And I get it. And I love that because that's like war on junk food, but not necessarily war on, you know, probably evolutionarily appropriate carbohydrates, which will be different for every person. And that's where, again, that CGM comes in.